Good afternoon, and welcome to Saints Peter and Paul. And we're so glad that we welcome you today, especially those of you who may be visiting us this weekend. Today, we celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. And now, as we begin this Mass, let us stand together and pray the prayer to the Holy Spirit that can be found on the cards in the hymnals. Holy Spirit, may the same fire of love which inflames the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary inflame our hearts so that through prayer and boldness in word and ministry, everyone in our parish and our local community will encounter Jesus, grow in faith, and witness the faith in word and deed. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that by the same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever enjoy his consolations. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And we do ask you to replace these cards for today's readings, which can be found at number 991. Again, that's number 991. And then please join us in singing our gathering hymn number 501, Take Up Your Cross.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind God's mercy and love. Lord Jesus, you raise us up to new life. Lord, have mercy. You free us from our sins, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day, I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will not speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like a fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thirsty for
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to our God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord. No such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
When I was a lay person, I always thought about being a priest, that what I do is like wake up on a Sunday morning, dust myself off, go into church and say something off the cuff that's kind of holy, and then go golfing or watch TV the rest of the day. And that's what I thought all priests did. You know, that's the whole schedule of life. But then after a while, after I started to enter the seminary, I realized that wasn't true. Instead, I thought that I would be such a great preacher that I would fill stadiums full of people wanting, hanging on my every word, wanting to listen to me. Or maybe I would be the greatest minister of all, you know, consoling and knowing just the right thing to say, when to say it to everyone. And the church would be growing and just filled to overflowing. Well, obviously, that's not the case. It's a start, mind you. It's a start to filling the stadium, but it's not quite there yet. And I know that I haven't done as well sometimes in ministering to others. I know that most of the time is taken up in finances and personnel issues and managing the parish. And then I look around and see all the parishes of the diocese and around the country, really, all dying and constricting. And as I'm looking at this, and I'm looking at what I used to think about, what I was signing up for when I became a priest, are two radically different things. And then it asks the question, do I want to stay? Is it hard? And that's really what Jeremiah is facing, because Jeremiah was called from his youth to go and preach God's word. He is one of the penultimate prophets in the Old Testament. And yet, as he's going through, he's being persecuted, people are mocking him, he is being ridiculed and everything else. And so he says, why, you know, you duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. It's not what I signed up for when I became a prophet of the Lord. I thought everything would be great. People would listen to me, they would come back to the Lord, and all would be well. And it didn't happen. And the same is true for Peter. Peter is expecting life through on God mode. And God mode, for those of you who don't know, who aren't into computer games, is when you have a code in the computer game and you all of a sudden, you never die, you never get injured, you have unlimited power and ammo and whatever, and you just romp through the game on easy mode. And that's called God mode. But Jesus has a different view of God mode. God mode as one who's going to be denied by the religious authorities, suffer, die, and rise. And Peter's not on to that. God forbid, Lord, should that ever happen to you. I didn't sign up for a persecuted and a crucified Christ. And so what of it then? How do we answer that expectation that's been changed or rejected? And it's through Jeremiah. I have a burning heart within me. The fire cannot be contained. You can have that fire of the Holy Spirit within you, recognizing that Jesus Christ has called Jeremiah to be a prophet. And no matter what is happening on the outside, no matter how many people are rejecting him, he knows in his guts that he is called to be a prophet. And so then he cannot shut up. He cannot do anything but be that prophet of the Lord. Peter as well could have said, well, gee, you call me Satan, I'm out of here. You know, and not only that, I don't want to listen to this, suffering stuff. But Peter loves Jesus too much to turn back. Do you love me, Lord? Three times at the end of the Gospel of John, Jesus asked Peter. And every time he says, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. It is that love that is within Peter's heart, which is that thing that's burning inside of him and causing them to stay. And I think those are the two things that we all rely upon, even all the troubled times. I know that's what I rely on, knowing that God has called me to be a priest. In my guts, in my bones, I know that is my calling. But more than that, I love Jesus Christ too much to put down that cross and go my other way. To put down and say, well, it's too hard. This isn't what I signed up for. I don't want to. It's not easy. And when we say it's not easy and turn away, then we are denying that cross and taking off and doing what we want because it's a lot easier to do that. We have that in our lives. A lot of times, whether it's a career, whether it's a marriage, whether it's how we take care of our family, our parents, you know, in a million and one ways, we always have in the back of our mind of how this is going to work. And it doesn't turn out that way. Remember, my dad, I always thought with him getting Alzheimer's, I would just be along, and then one day, who are you? Aw, isn't that beautiful? And instead, it was the agonizing thing of him asking me 50 different times the same question within an hour. That's not what I envisioned. But out of love, about being called, you answer those questions. We all have crosses in our life. All things that we have in our mind that how it would turn out, but it doesn't turn out that way. And instead of turning away from it and denying, recognizing that Jesus Christ has called us to where we're at this time. He has called us to the state of life we're currently in. And knowing not only that we've been called, that through the love of Christ, we are able to carry that cross and be crucified with him, so that we will rise with him one day. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. Into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. That's one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We bring all our petitions before our Heavenly Father.
For the efforts at Eucharistic revival to renew the church by enkindling in the hearts of all the faithful a living relationship with Jesus in the Holy Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those whose dedication to the Word of God brings them insult and persecution, may Christ's example and our prayerful support keep them true to the faith they share with us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this parish family of pilgrims journeying in faith, may Jesus strengthen the will of each of us to take up our cross and follow him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Lord to prosper the work of all who labor and to show his compassion to the unemployed and underemployed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, that they may not lose heart, but be renewed in faith and trust in our Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased loved ones, that they may rest with the Lord for all eternity, especially Ella Loyett and Bill Graham, as well as George Silhavy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and answer all our petitions, for they're offered through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of his church.
O Lord, may the sacred offering confer on us always the blessing of salvation, so that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. By his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. By ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. With the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, spouse with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, John, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Mm-hmm. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
For those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. Amen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit me not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Oh,
Let us pray. Lord, renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you that, being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you're having a wonderful weekend and day. My name is Liz Dalton, and I'm here for hospitality and funeral hospitality. They are entirely different committees, but they are a lot of fun and warmth that you bring to people. Hospitality is the group that has all of the fun activities for our parish, like the ice cream socials we've had this summer, and our fall event will be the anniversary brunch that'll be in October, and then we have several other functions that we're in charge of. The funeral hospitality is the committee that helps those when they've lost their loved one. We provide a luncheon for you, and we help you through those trying times, helping you to enjoy your time with your friends and family and not have to worry about entertaining them. These committees are available to all of you, and I'd love to have you serving on them. Out in the gathering space this weekend, we are hosting the food for you. It's just a light snack, but I'd appreciate you stopping by and maybe signing up for one of these committees or both of them. I think you would enjoy them. They're fulfilling, and we have a lot of fun. Thank you.
This Wednesday is Divine Mercy Adoration, beginning at noon and lasting a full hour, to pray for our parish, school, and the whole world. Following the holy hour is the Divine Mercy Study Group, as usual. Also, men of the parish, please join us for That Man Is You, beginning next Sunday, September 10th, from 9 to 10:30 a.m. in Morris Hall. A full schedule of dates is in the bulletin. There is still time to financially sponsor our school for the new school year, and see the flyers at the entrance to the church for more information. And finally, as we get ready for the Collinsville Italian Fest, the weekend of the 15th and 16th, there are lots of ways to be involved. You can sign up to help the Knights with their Italian beef, the parish and school booth with their chicken sandwich combo, or this weekend only, order a custom Saints Peter and Paul Italian Fest t-shirt for just $20. This t-shirt must be ordered by this Thursday, so stop by the gathering space for more information.
And please stand. And finally, if you or anyone you know would like to become Catholic, It is becoming late in the game to get on board for to be received in Easter. So please contact the office sometime this week, because we'll be starting very shortly. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.